A lot of hard edges, unless it's really more forward, closer to you, then you get more hard edges. But it's still into the background, so you want it to be really soft, separate. These are the middle values. Darker values, using the same paint, only just deepening the quinacridone gold. Oh, I thought I'd do add a little bit of Payne's gray to that. Before I do that, though, I think I'm going to come in here. Getting closer and closer.
Thank you.
in the way. I paint on a drawing table, which I can't, weave. I mean, I'm so used to it. So I have it up higher in a kilt, so that's how I do it. This is low for me. The light is hitting some of them down here. Thank you. needed to add something dark over here, the dark leaves, because I didn't want the water of the fountain just running off the paper and your eye with it. So I have to like bring it back by bringing a dark forward. Before I can go back again and add more darks in leaves and stems. I'll leave that for now. I could bold dry it now, but okay, that's fine. Moving on to the watering can.
Catch a boy?
Rose.
Oh, Rose, yes. Yeah.
Having to reach way out like this, mm-hmm. and my drawing table is more like this.
Mm-hmm.
But if I'm getting down to more detail work, then I'm sitting down,
yeah.
like say the face on the cap. I'm really teeny, kind of sloppy here. to go fast here. I don't think it's weight.
Doesn't look like it does.
Get that sloppy. Lobelia plants here. And I have masked out on the top tips of the lily plants because the light was hitting them really bright. So I have that white, and then I'll come in with some more yellow tones up here, and then gradually get cooler down here into the more blue-green. So all this section is more on the cooler side. I don't know what my shapes are. I'm working pretty much dry on here. I didn't wet any of this down.
Could you maybe put the finished one on camera for a little bit, because it is kind of hard to show the plant.
Oh, is it?
The finished one behind here?
Yeah.
See where it's at.
So, yeah, I'm painting around the leaves of the lobelia, my first wash, and I go over it several times to get it darker, so I'm, you know, at the light stages right now.
Is that the same kind of watercolor paper as on the one original one you have there?
Yeah.
Oh.
Tried all the others before in the past, so this is my favorite.
Is it cold brush?
Yep. Mm-hmm. I like the soft effects. The paint kind of gets into it more, it's the thickness of it makes it softer. I want to dry the side here of the can because I don't want it to run into the spot I want it, the definition of it. Website, update that, make prints,
right.
Office work. Oh.
I'm here yet.
Actually, I drew this out last spring, and I wanted to get right into it, paint it. I was so excited, but then I had to update the website. And my website, and it took like 2 months, and then I had to do my husband's website. So the whole summer I'm just on the computer.
Yeah.
And I kept thinking, I want to paint. So then I guess it was saved, and I saved it for this demo. All that, all those months.
Yeah. website.
Oh, I've seen it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she has, and a YouTube presentation too. Mm-hmm.
She has a really good website.
Yeah.
And you did your own website?
Yeah.
That's you've got to see her website. Uh-huh. It's amazing. It really is.
That's part of my, I don't know, graphic design. Maybe I still am interested. I like doing that part too. Although, it takes some time.
So how long does it take you to
finish what? Well, let's see, not counting the drawing part, because that does take
a lot of time.
Yeah, just to think up all the elements where I want things to go, 2 weeks maybe on that, and then maybe another week or two on the painting part.
Something like that. Maybe could you take that whiteboard picture and say out loud what you say on the website about that white horse picture, because it is really elegant.
What I said on the website?
Well, it has to do with all your masking techniques and all your
I don't know.
I'll just use the white horse, but the white horse was particularly saved with the
who's got a droid or an,
No, I can't remember.
Look up
her
website.
On there.
You know what? I'll look on my droid and see
what
you fit. I'm curious now.
Oh, yeah, really thin, wispy areas. I did look at, I mean, I masked it out, but that same
was but then when you come back in with the color on that pure white thing and you put in just tones, and I bet you just talk about what you, how you spray and soften and soften and spray, that sugar on your, you have to see the white horse.
You're talking about
shaping
the white.
I mean, it was this big blob of white.
Yeah.
Oh, really white.
Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of fun part, you know, when you get everything done, and then I take off the mask, and bam! white horse. Drastic. So, yeah, it's just a matter of using the same colors that I have in the painting, the mauves, purples, and just basically putting in the shadows and the form of the horse. I have some other colored yellows and pinks, rose, you know, under its belly. It's more bringing up the colors from the grass or up underneath him. And deep in the dark and under his mane, so that really stands out.
Okay, now move it around under the camera so that
I don't have an internet connection. Okay, now, since I can't tell you what's going on with the horse, you all have to go to her website. Okay, that forces you to check her out.
Is it just www.gailvass.com?
That was seen by our house, too. We have country roads all around us, and this white horse is out in his corral, and there's a barn on the side, and then there was black-eyed Susan around the horse like that. It was just perfect for painting. And of course I added, you know, the effects.
Well, you have about 5 more minutes, so if you just want to talk about your next process of how you finish up.
Okay, basically, yeah. The spout, I added just a little more rose. You know, it's a little more looser with this. You can kind of bring in a little more color to it, not just all lavender everywhere. And I added some quinacridone gold, so it kind of like almost a rusty feel to it, and I used the same colors into the background of the handle. And I lifted off this part last because that's really bright into the light. And on the inside of the can is the same colors, only deeper ultramarine and passion purple. That really deepens the effect. I'll mix that up. And when that's all dry, I've got to go over it again to really deepen it. It's more ultramarine. Ooh, I think, and I don't know if I can just paint it gray in there or not, you know.
Coming. And next month is Karen Knudsen. So, and then after that, of course, we have our spring show at Minnetonka. So, and Laura's patiently waiting to get your entries in. So make sure you get that done. So, thank you again, Gail.
Very nice.